Hey everybody, it's Chris, the Blue Collar Beer Gourmet. As promised, I'm going to be starting the Blue Collar Gentleman series, and part of the Blue Collar Gentleman series is going to have sub-themes within it. There will be men's health, there will be men's style, and this one of the sub-themes is beer glasses, something that means a great deal to me. I personally believe you should try to make every effort to drink your beer out of the proper beer glass. But a little bit more on that in just a moment, because today's is well, I chose today's beer glass for a very specific reason. Today's beer glass is the pint glass. Now, this is one that I picked up at a New Belgium tasting. Real quick, I'm just going to say what I usually say in regards to New Belgium. Just because New Belgium has had great success does not mean they are corporate. There's a distinction between successful and corporate. New Belgium likes to grow, likes to expand, likes to move forward. They're not in the business of buying out other breweries, changing their recipes, cheapening their recipes, and still calling it craft beer. So that's why New Belgium is not corporate. They're successful. Okay, soapbox down. Now, these actually go by a few different names. They're also known as Beckers, Nonics, or Tumblers. However, this is usually what should be called a Nonic. Notice the distinction here. This is just straight up and down. This has a little groove here, almost to make it easier for holding. The other distinction between this is a 16-ounce glass, this is a 20-ounce glass. Considering that a pint is 16 ounces, this should never really be called a pint glass, but it is often called a British pint glass, and I've even called it a British pint glass because that's what the beer glass set that I bought, or that rather Nancy got me for Christmas, said it was. If you want to call it a British pint, I suppose you can, but really it shouldn't be because it is 20 ounces and a pint is 16 ounces. So, what's the deal with the pint glass? Well, the pint glass is inexpensive, it's not exotic, and it's easy to stack. As you can imagine, you can put lots and lots and lots of these in here. And when I say not expensive, I'm going to give you some quick facts that I got from Amazon. Currently, you can get, and these are all plain varieties, mind you, and this is also this style as opposed to the Nonic. But you can get a two-pack of these on Amazon for $9.69. You can get a four-pack for $15.75. You can actually get a six-pack, mind you, a six-pack for what, 80 cents cheaper for $14.95. Six-pack, $14.95, four-pack, $15.75. You get a 12-pack for $20.27. What's more, if you've got a restaurant supply store very close to you, I'm not even sure how cheaply you could get these, but I would imagine for plain ones, very, very cheap. Of course, there's thematic ones. I saw some that were Game of Thrones. There's a Star Trek line of pint glasses. Whatever your fancy, whatever suits you. What I am going to say about this particular glass, and you know, there's going to be purists out there who disagree with me, and that is, if you don't have any other glass to pour your beer into, use this. Now, in a second, we're going to go over some of the styles and varieties that this glass is actually lends itself to. But you know, if you don't have, say, a Pilsner glass for your Pilsner, or you don't have a stemmed IPA glass for your IPA glass, use this. Every once and again, you will encounter a beer that says right on the can or right on the bottle, drink directly from bottle or drink directly from can. If that's what the brewer says to do, then that's what I do. I always go with the brewer's recommendation, even if it doesn't seem to make a whole lot of sense to me. If a brewer tells me to put, well, we'll get into this at some point, but if a brewer tells me to put a red ale in a tulip glass, I'm going to do it because I figure, you know, they had something in mind when they brewed this. So, and they've experimented with enough, they know what to use. So, as I said, this is the first in the series. This is the pint glass. This is 16 ounces. Now, what kind of beers do you use this for? Just about everything. It's usually used for ales rather than lagers. So lagers, pilsners, those don't you don't normally use these. You don't normally use these for American IPAs either. However, if you are drinking the British, if you are drinking a British IPA, this is a perfectly acceptable glass to drink it out of. But now, if you go to Beer Advocate and you look up beer glassware, you will find the longest list of varieties for this particular glass. Just to give you some idea, porter, okay? Porter. What kind of porter? Well, whether it's American, Baltic, or English, a porter belongs in this glass. Red ale, whether it's American or Irish, it belongs in this glass. If we're talking stouts, whether that be American, English, Irish or foreign slash export stout goes in this glass. Now, when I was looking at these glasses and looking at the varieties of pint glasses, there is a new style out now called stubby. Imagine taking this glass down to about here, making it big and round like so. Here's the deal, okay? I'm 5'9", I'm almost 300 pounds. The last thing I need is something right in my hand showing how much stubbier I am, how squat and stubby I truly am. Now, if you're tall and slender, good luck, good for you. That's great. Take your tall, you know, take your squatty glass, your pint glass, and enjoy it. Not for me. Like I said, the last thing I need is something saying, hey, in case you hadn't noticed, this is a short, fat guy. So that's why I won't be using the stubby, but I did note it out there, and it is in fact a pint glass. It does carry 16 ounces like this. Also, there's another variety that I seem to see a lot of these out there lately. They have a bullet right here. There'll be an actual bullet, and the glass will be sort of indented to make accommodation for that bullet. And I think it's sort of a joke, meaning a beer and a shot. I'm not sure. If that's your scene, great. Here's the thing about those, you can't stack them though. I mean, you can stack them, I guess, but not. It seems like something that you're basically lending yourself, you know, something to break. So, anyway, this is the standard glass. And as I said, if you don't have any other glass out there, and we are going to go over other types of glasses, as I said, this is just the first, and the reason I chose this as the first is that I think this should be what you do with, I mean, this is what you should use if you don't have anything else. So what I'm saying is go to Amazon, go to your restaurant supply store, pick up some of these so that you've got some for yourself, some for your friends. And one more thing about glasses, real quickly, trying to make this video less than 10 minutes, so I'm going to try to stay focused here. One, you always want to wash your glasses by hand. You always want to let them air dry. Sometimes the dishwasher will leave a residue that can affect the outcome of your glass. And also, even if you have a lint-free cloth to dry it with, well, if you're going to dry it with a cloth, dry it with a lint-free cloth, like an old flour sack. But oftentimes, those that are not lint-free, you will find lint all throughout your beer that will affect the head. So, all in all, if you don't have anything else to put your beer into, put it in this. Mind you, as I said before, if it does say drink directly from bottle or can, as the brewer instructed, do that. But otherwise, you're looking for a glass to put it in. Put it in these. Get a four-pack of these. As I said, a four-pack was $15.75. A six-pack was $14.95. These don't have to be sturdy. You're going to be going through them fairly regularly, so you don't have to buy the top of the line. Okay, guys, that's about it. The one last thing I am going to say about your beer glass, and we, you know, one more time, I think I've said this far too many times, we are going to be going over other glasses and other varieties of glasses. But the other thing you want to do before you drink out of your beer is you want to take good clean water. You want to run it through your glass, run it around your glass. It makes the beer hold onto the glass better or distribute through the glass better. If you go to some of your favorite breweries, I promise you, when you see what they have what's known as a Santa flush or a star flush. Sometimes they'll turn it upside down. They'll press it down in this little fountain, which sprays water up into your glass before they pour water into it. That's exactly what you're supposed to do. And maybe sometime I'll go into the exploits of why it's important to do that and what the benefits are to that. But until next time, guys, I appreciate you watching this video. If you liked it, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you haven't checked out my blog, Fat 50 and Running a Marathon, please do so. It's my journey from turning this into a runner's body so that I can run a marathon sometime during the year that I turn 50, which will be 3 years from now. So guys, until next time, drink good beer, drink it out of the proper glass, and cheers.